Welcome to Rent Memorial Stadium, where you see the Portland Stags, who've come up here to place their battle against the Seattle Rainmakers. Portland Stags 6-1 for the 2014 season. Their one loss, though, coming from the Rainmakers. Rainmakers, who are 4-4, ranked number 3 in the Western Conference. They are battling for that number 1 spot to the playoffs in the Western Conference. And we are coming at you live from Rent Memorial Stadium with MOU Live. Seattle Rainmakers, of course, with their home crowd advantage, as you see them listening to the national anthem being played before the game. There they are, the noise getting started from the crowd. Cheering on both teams as they came out, quite loud. As the Rainmakers coming off of a tough loss last week up in Vancouver, where they brought a skeleton crew and got punished for it, losing their worst game of the season. But coming out here, playing Portland Stags, another team they know well, and the only team that they have, the only team that's beat Portland so far. This is Jake Cooper and Dave Bistock coming at you from Renton Memorial. Here you see the flip is Danny Tridiak. Looks like he's going to get the choice. You see Danny Tridiak over there. Nathan Schorsch, the GM for the Stags on the left side. Right now, not much weather to be speaking of. The flag blowing quite a bit. But threatening rain earlier today. Right now, as you see, zero precipitation, 62% humidity. And a light wind, but in Renton Memorial, it has been gusting plenty. So we'll see if that light wind stays or if it picks up and makes this game a little junkier than it otherwise would be. Welcome, Dave.
Thanks, Jake. Good to be here. Glad to finish out the Rainmakers' home season here in Renton. I'm thinking the rain was brought on by them. What do you think?
That's right. When they show up, they just bring it with them. The cloud just flying after them.
And the Stags all showed up without any women, so there you go.
Stags come up here. You know, this is the second of their three meetings. The Seattle Rainmakers season, it's 10 games. Right now they are 4-4. One of those wins coming against the Stags, as we said. This game, of course, against the Stags, and their final game also against the Stags. So they do have an opportunity to take down that number one seed. Portland, for them, are going to have to just control the game front to back. Unlike last year, the Seattle Rainmakers have been showing that they can close out games, so Portland's going to have to control it starting early and all the way through. Of course, Cody Bjorklund back, a major player. So is Eli Friedman, of course, one of the Callahan winners. And Bjorklund and Friedman are going to team up, I'd imagine, for quite a few points for Portland here.
Big players for Portland, and definitely Seattle's defense going to need to hone in on them and put some stops, maybe throw some junk, break it up on the Portland plays that will likely center around those guys.
Absolutely. Seattle keys to the game, of course, is that disruptive defense you were just talking about. You know, the Portland offense doesn't really base off of a few key players, but that might be because Bjorklund wasn't there. Seattle keys are going to be to really keep the disc moving. You know, use those low stall throws, make the stall never get beyond one or even two. And, of course, find Donnie Clark. That man is a scoring machine.
He's quite an athlete, that one. Scores a few goals. And, yeah, the Seattle offense, real quick movement generally, so those low stall throws coming through for them. Both teams taking the field here, getting warmed up. The crowd getting riled up and getting excited for this showdown here against these Northwest rivals.
If you notice, the Stag side, you're looking at a lot of easy throws, some benders in the wind. On the Seattle side, it's looking a little more fun. Some people throwing giant scoobers over there from Trotter, a couple of invert tries from Kalmakis. You're seeing a little more silliness, almost preparing for a junk D.
Yeah, I like to see the Seattle silliness. It's a good quality, I think. But both teams, I'm sure, ready to bring it here in 4 minutes when the first pull goes up. Getting used to the wind, throwing some upside downers, jumping around, jump up, getting down.
I'm just trying to have a little fun out here and get riled up so they can start hammering it away, try to bring it up to that 3-1, 4-1 lead and control that game from the very beginning. put a little fear in the opponents to think that, you know, once this first quarter's over, the whole game's over, we've taken it.
It's certainly a game of runs, but the team that comes out early with momentum definitely has the energetic advantage. So it behooves both teams to come out early firing and get on the board. But as we've seen all season long, comebacks are quite possible.
Yeah, you know, especially last season from Seattle. But this time we're going to focus for a second on Eli Friedman, who has, he doesn't lead in goals or assists. He's got a solid number of both, 15 goals, 17 assists this season. He is the Stags' lead scorer, but the Stags are scoring through almost everybody, about 80% of their players on average score in each game. But he does lead the entire league in that quiet stat, the completion percentage. 97% is not something you see too often out of any player, much less somebody who's making the difficult throws and getting guarded by the toughest matchups in the game.
You would expect that sort of percentage from maybe someone who's catching goals all the time, but Friedman, you'll see him on both sides of the disc. That's a really impressive stat, that 97%. But good all around. Friedman coming up as a young player was impressive, and now that he's finding his own, just becoming more and more of a threat for Portland.
That's right. He's willing to take risks, but those risks are working, of course. And that's the kind of thing you don't really see in posters. You don't see in a highlight reel. It'd be a real long highlight reel. Watch these 100 throws and notice that only 3 of them were incomplete. But that's the kind of thing that top players are looking for.
And for Seattle side, Eddie Feely, a rookie to MLU this year, but not a rookie to Ultimate, certainly. Defensive handler. He gets a lot of their toughest assignments and just jumps in and guards the jibbers out of the offensive threats. So we might see those two lining up against each other. He's an anchor for D conversions. Eddie's a good handler on the other side of the disc once he gets it back. Real smart player with an 89% completion rate. Not quite 97, but for a defensive handler, generally, you know, once the defensive team gets it, they're taking more risks and they don't get it quite as much, not touching it and getting used to having the disc in his hand as much as Friedman, perhaps.
That's right. Often that defensive line is a little riskier because they're often a little more athletic and willing to play that deep ball game, the jump ball game, and just say, look, we're on the defensive line because we're such good defenders.
And here we go. The pull is up. Rainmakers pulling to the visiting Stags.
See the Stags coming out in horizontal offense as they go straight for a set play that's going to run through, it looks like, Laurie, who gets it on the far sideline. Laurie looking off the deep shot. Trapped there as the Rainmakers are going Mandy. That's Allison Hall moving it all the way back towards us, towards Strout, and all the way through to Kenton. Back and forth, the deep players awfully deep. These cutters are really stranding the handlers a bit as you've got these one-on-one matchups. Folks looking close. Mark's almost straight up here, a little worried about those hucks. You even see the defensive handlers coming off and guarding those hucks as well. As the Stags move it to the middle of the field. Still lots of lateral motion, not too many strikes directly upfield. See a lot of those break around throws to the far sideline through, I think that's Burton over there. Bringing it back to the center. All the way over, they've probably thrown it for 110 yards so far, but only made about 10 of them and make that only 3 now. Really taking their time, though, and looking confident. This is how you see those completion percentages get so high. There's the strike. They're only about 15 yards out now. Moves it over with a little break mark past Sliva to the goal for Mark Burton. Stags come out, putting that away, 1-0.
Good patient offense by the Stags. A lot of swings using the whole horizontal field. And then finding the openings, a nice inside-out flick from Norden upfield opens up. With the goal.
That's right. Gallagher kind of stopped guarding Burton for a second, thinking he was already pinned in a corner. That's such a small window. But Laurie had no problem hitting it.
Nice find. Burton, of course, playing last year here in Seattle, so... some trades up and down the I-5 corridor here between last year and this year. Khalif El-Salam, who's from Seattle, playing for Seattle, of course, played on Portland last year.
That's right. They traded deeps almost.
That's right. See those guys match up, perhaps.
Let's see it, McKibben!
Now we'll have the Seattle Rainmakers offense take the field and get to battle that out. It's almost two teams where you have offensive lines and defensive lines. Here's Seattle O centering to McKibben as they do the exact same thing, a horizontal stack to a set play of El Salam coming across while the Stags go man defense. Stags defenders taking the field. Rather than a straight up force, though, they are forcing flick. There's not much room to speak of, but a miscommunication goes straight over to the Stags. Stags push it through to McGinn. McGinn with a little bladey shot over to Faria. Back to the center, it's looking quite open as the Seattle offense struggles to keep on their men on defense. All the way to the side, Trotter on Hayes, and they burn it in for the first break of the goal. First break of the game, sorry, to bring them up 2-0.
And that was just an unforced error from Seattle. A couple of times in that offensive set, they had two cutters coming into the same spot. Right there, the thrower just kind of put it between them. Neither of them knew whether it was to them or what. And Davis just comes in, catches it, and gets the defensive O going for Portland. Punches it in and takes the 2-0 lead.
That's right. That was Adamson catching that goal. Excited to find himself in the end zone with the disc, of course. And I think it's exactly what you said. There were two cutters there. It was El Salam and I believe it was Trotter who were cutting into the same space. The thrower might not even have decided who it's going to. He just puts it to the space and says, you guys figure it out.
Not a great move. Not one that's going to get you that high throwing percentage.
Of course, they'll get another chance. It's the same line for both teams out on the field. Of course, Stags will keep that line. They just succeeded. And you're never going to pull an offensive line after a quick break like that. You want to get them in their flow. And we have that center. This time they're going a set play out of a vertical stack. Zerup brings it well up to McKibben. McKibben straight to the center to Salam. A little stranded for Rupp as he finds Norton on the far sideline. Again, it's a force flick, man defense, vertical off. Wow, and the question is, can McKibben keep it in? The officials say absolutely. Puts it up to Tridiak. Tridiak with his famous hammers.
Wow, great D.
Incredible D there.
Davis coming across with a huge layout block in front of El Salam at the goal line.
And now the Seattle offense finds themselves playing D again. Danny Tridiak, one of those scary players because he'll put it anywhere, but Davis was ready for it. Showed his athleticism, and there's a drop on the other side by Hayes there.
Couldn't hang on. A little knifey forehand cutting out to the side. It's a tough catch, and he just couldn't make it.
Well, these silly throws are being punished. You might see this game slow down a little bit as McKibben dishes it back to the Sharkness. Sharkness playing a little give and go. Moves up Danny Tridiak, who finds himself in the same position. And instead of the big hammer, just picks a little flick up to Harkness for the goal. Puts it in. Portland 2, Seattle 1.
Sam Harkness, give and goes all the way across the field and into the end zone. Credit him with that one. Lots of work from the Seattle native Sam Harkness finding his way into the goal and getting Seattle on the board with 6:45 left in the first.
That's right. Taking a little time there. As you see, Tridiak's hammer is just an unbelievably athletic play. Folks know that the hammer's coming. Tridiak is kind of famous for him. He is, it's a threat. He puts it anywhere, and that flick mark isn't going to stop him. When you see that flick mark and the disc is in Tridiak's hands, you can almost expect that hammer.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly what happened. Made a big athletic play and got the disc back in Portland hands.
And that hammer just hung up there a little too long, giving Davis a chance to come off across, which Davis drooled at.
There's Eddie Feely with the pull. Eddie Feely, we've talked about being the defensive general for Seattle. As the Stags offense, through Norton, is doing again three handlers back, four cutters in a horizontal stack downfield. Though those cutters being pretty active, you don't really see lanes right now. They're going wherever they want. And a man defense that is a little bit pull off the backs and make it harder for the throwers, trying to stick them back. And it's working right now as those defensive cutters are so far downfield, you can't even see them on the screen. Comes across, hits Friedman. There's Eli Friedman, who pushes it up to Allison Maul. Norton still with that real slow, patient offense. You don't see a lot of risky throws. You don't see miscommunications. And there's a bit of a risky throw, and it's far too deep for Friedman. real tough shot looking at somebody's numbers, looking directly at their back to find that disc, even if you're on offense, even for Friedman there without a defender on him.
Strout got a little wide-eyed, saw his buddy. Friedman wanted to put it up, but just too much mustard behind it. Friedman, no chance at it.
Too spicy. There's Eddie Feely coming in with the disc. Moves it up to Alex Duffel on this sideline. See if that Seattle defense can bring another break. Pushes it back to Feely, always a safe bet. Feely, the rock of the defense. He's going to be their main handler. Sleeve on the far sideline as the Stags offense finds themselves on defense trying to play man. Feely puts it up deep for Rory Gallagher, who's got to chase it down. Can't quite make it.
Looked like he had a chance, but Feely puts too much behind it. Gallagher with a nice attempt and open. Definitely steps on his man. A good choice, just a little too far for Feely. They trade pucks that go a little too far, and Portland takes the disc back.
A little surprised Gallagher didn't bid there, and I think the crowd was too. You heard them a little upset. They wanted to see something fun. As you've got...
And another flick... Huck going too far. Skip Sewell pumping his fist. Maybe got a piece of it, but excited either way that the Rainmakers get the disc back.
You know, Laurie definitely had steps there. He was deep and open. Shot just couldn't go. It might. It's hard to tell from here. It might be drizzling out there.
And a little breeze coming sort of from the far end of your screen towards us. Another turnover in the lane.
Getting a little sloppy here as Laurie picks it up. And what a catch there.
Nice grab.
Absolutely. That's Mark Burton playing for the Stags this year. As there's about 15 yards out, Strout with the disc, moving it over to Norton. And there's a call right before a bid by Sleva, which can't quite make it. And the disc looks like it's going to come back.
And Rainmakers coach Steve Gustin running out to the field.
Timeout time is my time.
For the timeout.
Not sure why he's calling that timeout. The defensive line is on the field. That is, Seattle started pulling that disc. Their D's on the field, so they're not using this timeout to actually exchange players, which is often what they do a timeout for. They'll get the disc on the defense, call the timeout, and put their offensive line in.
Yeah, expect a stunt D on the end zone from the Rainmakers. Trying to mix it up. Here you see the approach. And just a great grab by Burton tracking the throw. A lot of throws going errantly out in front of guys. Burton says, not going to let this one turn over. And he gets it, resets it, then the timeout call. And we'll see what the Rainmakers bring on D to try and disrupt Portland Stags' end zone set.
Ended up being a good call by Gusson because that whistle went off right before the assist. Passed a bidding Todd Sleva.
Had there been no timeout call, it would be 3-1 Portland. As Gusson heads back, see what he's got going for his Rainmakers. Looks like a double disc.
Rain is starting to come down now. It's a light miss, but that's enough to get the disc plenty wet. Double team.
Open hammer shot. Doesn't
on
take
Norton.
It.
It's going to be coming back. Disc was never put in officially. See a lot of folks wearing gloves right now. It's a 10-yard penalty for Norton for the Stags. And you're going to see these marks force and flick now with that wet disc, wet ground. The backhand, you have so much more hand on the disc. It's a lot easier to control it with the forehand. Just two little fingers, not a lot of grip. And those are a lot of the shots that are sliding out too fast.
Players sliding as well as the Stags forced to retreat back to the 50 and behind.
Successful defense by Seattle, though the looked like the Friedman Norton show is going on. Up to Laurie. Laurie just a few yards out and dings it in. It's going to be called a goal for Breeze Strout.
Nice inside out forehand from Norton again to gain about 25, 30 yards. And put the Stags back right in front of their end zone. And a quick shot to Strout, getting his high fives coming off the field after a long point with a lot of turnovers.
Yep, you're going to see this just a little dishy. And Stroud doesn't even bother jumping, making sure he's clear of the line. He's just going to catch it. It's that kind of typical Portland for this year of high completion. Don't worry about making sure you're in the end zone. Don't worry about, you know, those little things. Just make sure the disc is in your hand, in your possession. And if we're 2 inches out of the end zone, that's all right. We'll put it in.
Good focus there from Stroud. Had a couple Rainmaker deep players on either side of him. Brings the disc in. It turns out he was inside the end zone by about 2 inches or so. And Portland Stags up 3-1 with 3:12 left in the first period.
Seattle offense just got to put it in, get their defense back on the field. It's not much of a hole. It's just one break. But you don't want to feel behind the whole game. You want to feel like you're controlling it. And right now that is with the Stags. Stags showing why they're number one on the West Coast right now.
Ooh, opening.
As El Salam chooses not to shoot it down to Tommy Fresh, who is looking with some steps deep, instead moving it over. Tough shot up to Koss. Koss, who takes no time, saying, I'll hit Fresh if you won't.
Nice bid on his fingertips, doesn't quite bring it in.
It's a tough catch. He went lefty for that. The disc blading into the right, a wet disc. There's no real way to grip it there. It just kind of hits right off a couple of the fingers and goes into the ground with Rosado.
Let's stay live for the defense, Seattle!
And Portland bringing the vertical stack this time.
That's right. Man defense, both sides. We're seeing a flick mark, which just shows how slick it is out there. And that's exactly what happens. You put that flick mark on, and a lot of those forehands slide out a little soon, go right into the ground. As Reed Koss pushes everyone back. Vertical stack, one person behind. Koss with the quick little dink to El Salam, who's on the goal line. Moves it back to Koss. Koss looking for anybody. Just any completion forward is going to be a goal. But instead, he puts it back to Rupp. Rupp about 5 yards out, moving it over to Koss. All the way over. And Jimmy Chu can take all the time he needs to pull it in on the far sideline, bringing Seattle up within one of Portland.
Good patience from the Rainmaker end zone offense. El Salam getting wide open on that very first cut, but not quite in. And they swing it around. And Koss puts it well out in front of Jimmy Chu, who has steps and time to run on for the goal. Seattle 2, Portland Stags 3.
Seattle offense looking a little more comfortable now, not taking those risks, not bothering to try to jump and do fancy footwork to get into the end zone on that close sideline. Instead, they thought, you know, we'll bring it back a little, give ourselves some room, and swing it all the way over to the far side. You saw how much room Jimmy Chu had there. Giant window, throw it anywhere catchable. Defense can't get there.
Good patient offense, and utilizing the width of the field on the end zone is a smart choice there from the Rainmakers.
Eddie Feely launches a pull. Minute 41 left on the clock. Starts as soon as Breeze Stroud catches it and centers it over to Norton. Back to Stroud again. That very deep sort of horizontal stack as the shot goes right away to Bjorklund. Bjorklund, who before the disc is even halfway to him, gives a shrug looking back thinking, why'd you throw that? It's going straight out of bounds.
A little wide-eyed there from the Stags. Bjorklund steps, but it sails out.
Feely trapped on that sideline. Moves it all the way over to Gallagher, who's boxing out a little bit. Catches it nice and easy. Back to Feely. You're seeing Feely about every third catch here. Feely moves it up to Alex Duffel. Getting a lot of yards on each throw here. Back to Feely. Feely's been every other for the Seattle defense. And Schneider blocked a little bit by Gallagher. Can't hold on to it as Laurie's going deep. Shot comes from Bjorklund right away. Laurie's going to have to try to keep it in bounds, which he does. About 5 yards out on that sideline, and it's that same shot to Allison Hall. That same shot, lots of room, throwing it over to the opposite sideline. 43 seconds left in the quarter, where Portland's up 4-2.
Good quick attack on the transition by Portland. A little bit of a miscommunication again. Seattle sending two cutters into the same spot. They communicate about it, but Schneider not able to hang on there. Shot goes up to Laurie. Nice inside-out flick to Allison Hall in the end zone for an easy Portland goal on the transition.
You know, real nice eyes by Laurie. He was right next to the disc when that disc hit the ground, when Schneider bobbled it a bit. Right there, but instead of going and picking up the disc, he figures somebody else will do it. He shoots right away and doesn't have defender close to him. which allows Bjorklund to gain 40 yards right away on that quick transition.
And Laurie had tons of time to bring that one in the sideline. Probably could have even milked it a little bit more, but again, like you're saying, playing it safe, making sure there's a completion. Here you see Seattle crowd, hundreds and hundreds of folks out here in Redmond to celebrate the last home game of the season for the Rainmakers, decked out in their luau wear.
That's right, it's a luau day. In this nice, sunny, tropical, oh wait. Still raining as McKibben pushes all the way to us. 30 seconds left.
Yeah, Riley.
McKibben, Harkness. Harkness moves it up to Isaac Entz. Entz is going to take the shot to Salam. 20 seconds left on the clock. Salam skies and gets the disc. You hear the crowd loving it as Salam gets the double take and dances a bit, putting it in for Seattle.
Nice defensive pressure there. El Salam goes up, tries to get it. Little rattle there on the disc, and then goes back up again and catches it between the two defenders. Fired up. Only 17 seconds left in the first period.
You see the shot by Entz flying up. This might have just been a decision of El Salam catches everything. He goes up a little early, tricks a defender, lands, and then plucks it from the sky there.
And then spikes it on his head and through his legs.
That's classic Salam.
Classic. And we'll see if anyone can punch it in here in 17 seconds. Stags needing to, 16 seconds here, move it downfield quickly.
That's right. Koss playing general a bit, as they are, I'm sure, discussing how this is going to work. The clock not actually starting yet. The clock's going to start as soon as the Stags touch the disc after the pull. See it being pushed back up there. Apologies for that. Stags put it in, and there's a prevent defense by Seattle. They're keeping the Frost Giant, Isaac Entz, 6'6", deep.
Oh, great D. What timing, 8 seconds left.
As Todd Sliva says, you know, we're going to have a chance for this instead. Moves it over with 2 seconds left, shot to the end zone.
Oh, what a grab by Gallagher. Let's it go, but possibly a foul. Looks like it's probably a goal.
Did that just happen? Did he just hold on to that? John Ladd calling it a goal. Rory Gallagher with the last second Superman catches it one-handed in the rain. Everybody smiling on that one.
The crowd erupts, as do his Rainmakers teammates. Good heads-up play on the transition there. An amazing D out in the lane from the Rainmakers. Turns it around. A couple quick throws upfield. Firing flick into Gallagher, who lays out with a big grab. Hangs on. I think he let go of the disc there, but it looked like there was contact that knocked it out of his hand, and the referee calling it a goal with 0.5 seconds remaining.
That was it. Gallagher, I thought he thought he had to catch it before the clock hit zero. He just screamed out of nowhere, went horizontal. He must have bid with, what, a third of a second warning? Bid goes one-handed, gets it, sticks it, and that's a break for Seattle.
Quick twitch. And the Stags won't really have a chance here. As soon as they touch it, they'll launch it. But let's see if the clock allows the throw to go off. Not really.
Norton just hoping to get a foul there. Trying to draw a foul, get the 10 yards and restart. But with a double team, it's not going to matter. Bringing the first quarter to a close. 4-4. Portland coming out strong with a break right at the beginning to put it up 2-0. Seattle responding with what was a prevent defense, turning into an incredible shot with Gallagher pulling it down in the end zone.
Tying it up 4-4 with the crowd behind them. Getting set for the second period here. The Rainmakers huddle up, talk about their strategy coming into the second period. A little back and forth, both teams with breaks here in the first period. A couple of unforced errors, a couple long points with some hucks going out in front of their men. But all in all, an exciting first period of play.
That's right. A couple breaks, lots of turnovers from the offenses, but that's kind of what you expect when they were practicing, warming up for the game. It was perfectly dry out, and now there is a decent amount of misty rain, classic Pacific Northwest weather that both teams are used to, but you got to adjust those throws, adjust that strategy for the rain. welcome back as we start the second quarter. The Stags pull into Seattle offense. Seattle defense just pulled him out of a little hole with a great D by Todd Sliba. Shot by Ben Beener and that unbelievable catch by Rory Gallagher. As Seattle comes out, Cost streaking across. That's almost all of these opening gambits have been making some room and having somebody come across. El Salam counting on the foul there for the free throw, which John Ladd, official John Ladd, gives him. He's going to get 10 yards. And you'll see that Rainmakers offense in a vertical stack. Playing very standard offense. Cuts just coming from the back of the stack. Couple steps out and coming back in. Real bread and butter ultimate. As the Rainmakers push it back to McGibbon. It goes all the way around to Rupp. Hard flick force right here. Hard enough that they're getting some contact on the mark. Hammer all the way to Tridiak. Tridiak finally getting a taste of what it's like to be on the other side.
Wow, nice grab.
Rupp saves one of those floppy slide-out flicks. As the Seattle Rainmakers stranding their handlers a bit. As the handlers are backing up.
Whistle. Trotter open. See what the call is. Looks like it's going back.
Trotter open, I think, from a picked.
Hey, reload!
Looks like
reload!
Hancock.
Reload!
They're going to bring it back and penalize the Rainmakers 10 yards. You see there's some handler movement by nice defensive downfield Mandy by the Stags. Handler movement for Seattle, but the downfield cutters aren't really pulling back with the handlers, stranding them a bit. As Rupp has to go up and play pull down from the sky. Moves it up to Rosado. Rosado trapped on the sideline.
Ooh, nice bid.
Great bid there by Woodside.
Exciting.
Fresh gets it. Floats a 500 goal. And wow, Salam getting skied there by Hayes.
Hayes just had position. The throw didn't give El Salam much of a chance. Nice D by Hayes.
That's the second nice D by Hayes we've seen this game. As the Stags offense, well, now offense, starting well back in their own end zone. And there's a shot going off right away.
Ooh,
and a big collision. Big collision between Tridiak and it looks like Freya.
And Tridiak just zoned in on that disc. Freya had position, went up and got it. Tridiak clipped him, wasn't really looking at him. Freya looking like he's all right.
Tridiak ran over right away. Give Freya a little high five, let him know, look, I wasn't trying to do that, I was just trying to play defense. Looks like McGinn's going to come in with the disc. As the official show him exactly where he's coming in. It's going to be 10 yards up from the Stilata foul. As the Stags going into, I think they're a little confused. They set up in horizontal. And McGinn calling them into a vertical. And now some discussion between the officials.
Outside. Let's take this time to throw out a free frisbee.
Officials saying that, here you'll see that disc coming up. Tridiak just didn't see Ferre there, and that's why the disc had to come in with Ferre. He was the one fouled. He was the one in possession.
All right, let's go left.
Another nasty flick coming out. A lot of flicks going errantly, not to where they're intended. The wetness playing some role here.
You can see that calm nature as Tridiak goes up, gets the D. Everyone just real calm. Tridiak even having time to stop and make sure his shoes tightened. As a timeout is called, it was 6:36.
And we'll see roster switches here. Rainmakers will bring in
some water.
Some water, yeah. Roster, water.
Rainmakers taking a break. You think the last thing they need right out here is more water. That has been the bane of the offense so far, as we've seen so many of those flicks coming out sloppy. And the D is getting some easy stats as all they have to do is put their hand out and the disc comes right to them.
Some sloppy flicks from both sides, making for a couple exciting plays from the handlers, saving some of them. Rupp with a huge grab for the Rainmakers.
You see Breakmark here. Breakmark's an official merchandiser of the MLU, providing gear for all MLU officials and producing the official headwear of the league. That's keeping that rain out of their eyes. Breakmark produces high-quality custom ultimate gear for high school, college, and club teams. You can look for them at breakmark.com for all your ultimate apparel needs.
As Coach Steve Gustin heads back to the sideline. Rainmakers chatting. There's O'Brien trying to fire him up as they retake the field and the disc.
You can see on these close-ups all that rain coming down. It started off a beautiful day as they were warming up. At the beginning of the game, it just started misting where things were sort of wet, but I don't know if you'd call it precipitation yet. Just kind of in a cloud. And now it is undeniably raining. Rainmakers brought it.
See if they can bring it here. The long vertical stack set up looking down the field.
Very long vertical stack, as you see McKibben trying to draw off the disc. It probably doesn't work, though, because his jersey is probably soaking wet.
I'd say for effort.
Looking, it's almost easier to break the mark with a backhand than to try those flicks. Flick goes up to Koss, past the diving Davis. Koss moved it all the way to the far sideline with Trotter. Moves it up to Chu. They're going open side. You're going to have to break it to bring it back to this side, or else just jam it up that jam sideline. As Trotter decides, we can jam it up here. And moves it up to McKibben, who came streaking from a handler position. He is usually behind the disc. Sometimes that's a tricky little juke to do. Make a little upfield cut and fly, as you see that rain really coming down.
Nice cut from McKibben there. Handler defenders not used to having to chase their guys deep. As you see, the throw goes up, and McKibben well out in front. McGinn up with a chance at it. And through the wetness, the Rainmakers prevail and go up 5-4.
You know, Seattle, of course, used to playing in the rain, but this isn't like they're playing the Dogfish or, you know, the Boston Whitecaps or something. They're playing the Portland Stags, and, you know, Portland's used to practicing in this, playing in this. So it's really not the advantage it sometimes could be.
The rain really brings a test of focus to teams playing ultimate. You got to really concentrate on bringing that disc all the way in and just that added focus on the throws.
As Eddie Feely tries a roller pull, trying to roll it out that flick sideline, they're probably going to go for a trap right away, possibly even a double team. Unfortunately, that roller didn't really make it so far. And they are. They're going for the hope that they can stop that disc right away. As a hammer comes up. Ooh,
Gallagher, huge D.
As you see Friedman hoping for a foul, but Gallagher, I mean, he's not a former volleyball player, but he could be. Goes up and just spikes it. Crowd getting excited for Skip Sewell, who's going to have to lay out for a slidey throw by Pete Kalmakis. Pete the Greek trying one of those 40-yard flicks, and you've seen what that rain does.
Skip Sewell with a nice bid, not quite able to get there, very close.
Norden stuck again, gets a hammer all the way across. He was double-teamed, so there was a wide-open Kenton. As you see that, well, you hear that home crowd of many hundreds here at Renton Memorial. It is a packed stadium, rooting for the defense, as the Stags are trapped about 10 yards deep in their own end zone. Solid flick comes out.
Oh, wow.
Very bizarre play, as room is made for Friedman to get the disc. Floaty flick all around. But you're seeing a lot of open players, especially handlers, because the other defender, the handler defense, is coming and double-teaming the guy with the disc. Deep shot. Strout lasers it to Friedman. Friedman wide open, but those long flicks, so hard in the rain here.
We saw that same throw go too long in the first period of play. This time, Friedman wide open. Strout could have put something with a little bit more float on it, but sends the laser out the back of the end zone. Friedman covering a lot of ground to try and get there, left hanging.
You wonder if he just gave it so much mustard because so many throws are coming out floppy. Rubernack almost getting tricked by the defense, but manages to turn around and pull it with nobody there as another timeout is called by, it looks like, Rainmakers coach Steve Gussin. And here you're going to see a change out as offensive and defensive teams are going to switch it up.
Who wants a frisbee signed by the entire team?
For Portland, trying to put in what they'd hope their offense would just put it in, do business as usual.
The crowd getting fired up here. Ted Werbel giving out free Rainmakers swag here at the stadium.
You'll notice in this rain, a lot of the players wearing Friction gloves. Friction gloves is the official glove provider to the MLU. These all-weather gloves are specially designed for ultimate players. They combine the tackiness of receiver gloves with a rubberized grip for better catches and throws in this rain. You can look for Friction Gloves Catch of the Week throughout the season and get an official MLU pair for yourself soon at the MLU shop. You can visit frictionglove.com to learn more.
And here you see the hometown Seattle crowd cheering on their Rainmakers as the timeout coming to a close here.
You know, here in the stadium, those timeouts are almost looked forward to because Ted Warble gets out the t-shirt gun. You hear screams coming out. That's what you're hearing over here. Is Cloud slash MC Ted Warble. 4:14 left in the quarter. Portland down one as the Seattle offense has now taken the field. In place of the defense, this would be a break if they put it in. Moves it up to Salam. El Salam on the far sideline. Breaks it with a brick with a flick back to Rupp. Rupp all the way over to Tommy Fresh, who's going to go one-handed. Try to keep it in bounds. Got to get back on Bjorklund. Bjorklund over to Norton. All the way over to Davis. Davis moving it up the center to Laurie. Seattle crowd hoping for defense as Bjorklund shoots out a huge hammer, which Danny Tridiak manages to come up between the arms.
Nice D there by Tridiak without making any contact. Gets his hand up and in between the arms of Burton there. Let's take another look.
Real tough D to get. He's got to get the disc first and at least convince the officials that he didn't touch Burton in the meantime. But the gods of Ultimate decide they wanted Burton to get it.
Oh, Stags almost letting it go, but hanging on there on a quick turnover. McKibben showing us what that rain's doing to those flicks today. Sends a wobbler.
Gets a little frustrated, tries to bid on that 2-inch little corner shot, but can't quite get there in time.
Tie ball game, 5-5.
As it looks like Hancock brought that one in. There's Mark Burton, a little frustrated. One of his former teammates played together on the Rainmakers last year. A lot of those throws were from Tridiak to Burton. This time Tridiak is going up and preventing that score.
Tridiak proving himself useful on both sides of the disc there. A nice, clean defensive play. Not sure if Burton was just frustrated and not getting it or if he thought there was some contact, but in the replay it looked like a very clean D by Tridiak. But then the Rainmakers give it right back. And the Portland Stags with the counterattack.
That's right. I think Tridiak just a little jealous at seeing somebody else throw a hammer at Burton.
He wasn't going to let it go.
Oh, no. McKibben centering over to Koss. It's the old play. We've seen both sides. Stags and Seattle love to run it. It's a horizontal stack. The two people close to the disc clear out. Straight back. And the third comes across. That was McKibben that time. Moving it up to Entz. Entz in the middle of the field as they've gone into a flow offense. Man defense. Force flick from the Stags. As there's Davis on the mark. Good switch call. As Davis says, this Shark guy is a little too quick. Let's switch, but nobody switches onto McKibben. And McKibben, deja vu, finds himself in that far left end zone with the disc in his hands as the defender trails behind.
Good play there from the offense from Seattle. Quick throws, that's what we talked about, one of the keys of the game. Lots of quick movement, not any high stall counts there. Little give and go with Sam Harkness, we saw that. And then El Salam finishing the play with a nice up the line flick to McKibben, who's fired up about it.
Looks like McGinn there caught a little force of McKibben upfield. McKibben always one of the handlers going back and forth. McGinn says, you go upfield. And McKibben says, oh, okay.
Yeah. Conversation that McKibben probably doesn't want to repeat.
Eddie Feely not trying that roller pull anymore, not after what happened last time. Knocks it almost to the end zone as you hear the raindrop cheer from Renton Memorial. Disc moving center to Strout, coming all the way back over to King. King up to Strout with a little give and go. Feely chasing a little bit, trying to make sure Strout doesn't get the big shot. As Strout goes so deep, Feely chases, but Laurie is just too far back with the disc, moving it back to Norton. Seattle really respecting the deep looks from the Stags, which are allowing them to get open underneath a little more than maybe Gus might be excited about. Moves all the way over to this sideline with Bjorklund. As Norton keeps it in, rockets a high and floaty flick. It's going to be a battle.
Wow. Sewell comes over the top with a good team defense with Duffel and Sewell, and Sewell making sure that he gets that one. And then
this
nice
turns into a
Feely.
Turned into a clown point as Feely bids to keep it alive and immediately just says, timeout, we have the disc. Let's get this Salinas out.
Trying to call a timeout for a while there, we'll see.
But instead called down, called that Feely never had possession. It's a turnover as Norton gets the disc.
Either that or no timeouts left.
And Strout pulls it in from Norton on the far sideline. We're still trying to figure that out as Portland brings it up.
And Portland proving themselves good on the quick counterattacks here today.
You're absolutely right, by the way. That was a no timeouts left. That was their third timeout in the first half, which is not allowed. That timeout call became the turnover. And here you see Norton, that far flick sideline, where Stroud has just burned past Feely. Brings it in easily.
Feely
tied the game up.
Feely still shaking it off, not wanting to be the Chris Webber of this game.
That last turnover.
Got to keep track of those timeouts. Minute 20 left in the half. 6-6 tie ball game. And you're absolutely right. You know, that wasn't even a real turnover of sorts. It was a different kind of turnover, and still, the Stags defense managed to punish them within 5 seconds.
Any kind of turnover, you got to get right on D. And the Stags certainly punishing every time they're not, with several goals off quick Seattle turnovers.
Seattle hoping not to turn over this time as Davis rockets a high floaty shot. As it looks like a dominator offense by Seattle, they have a horizontal stack, but comically deep, just making room for those three handlers to do a little domination, as they do, between Rupp, Koss, and McKibben. Finally shooting it up to El Salam.
Trying for a sideways pancake there and just can't hang on. It was coming in pretty hot. And it's a tough grab any way you shake it, whether you reach out with one hand, try and go for two. That time, pancake catch, a little off the griddle.
That's right, hot and wet. Not the way El Salam wanted it there. As he comes off pointing at himself, saying, my fault, guys. And this time the timeout is going to happen legally by the Stags. 48 seconds left in the half as they pull on a little offense-defense switch.
And 48 seconds, plenty of time here for the Stags to try and bring it in. We'll see what they can do with the time left.
If you want to know what ultimate players do when they're not on the field, they are playing spike ball. It's a little bit volleyball, a little bit like four square, and a whole lot of awesomeness. You can get $10 off normal retail online using promo code MLURocks1 at spikeball.com. That's MLUROX1 at spikeball.com.
MLU does rock.
MLU rocks one. That is something I try at all of the online stores. I was buying tea earlier today. I just typed it in. They sent me some Spikeball stuff. It was amazing.
Huh. Spikeball taking over the internet.
So here we've got the Stags who brought in their offensive line trying to capitalize on this turnover. 48 seconds left as the Seattle D takes the field as well. Alex Duffel on the mark as Eddie Feely, who is on Breeze Strout, who's behind the mark, but looks like he's going to peel off as Strout backs up as far as he can from Feely, hoping to draw Feely away from double-teaming that mark. Offense set up in not even a stack, just kind of four players moving around the field.
I think it's going to be vertical eventually.
It did. It shifted into vertical right at the end. There's some cool military formation as Laurie gets the disc far sideline. You can hear the Run Memorial crowd shouting defense.
Oh, Duffel gets a piece of it.
Alex Duffel with the over-the-side little Daddy Duff move. Leaps off the left foot, goes with his right, and breaks it up. There's 27 seconds left. Eddie Feely hoping to bail out, but instead the bailout comes from Todd Sliva, who moves it back to Feely. Feely, 17 seconds left. finds Gallagher only 5 yards out.
Pushes it right up the middle to Ben Beener. Home crowd loving that one. 11 seconds remaining as Seattle moves it up by one.
Beener all smiles, gives the disc back to Feely. They'll be coming on the D with only 11 or 12 seconds here remaining.
You know they're going to put... There's Rory Gallagher. Just finds that easy shot right to the middle. Threading the needle as a frustrated Davis. Maybe felt it was something he could do about it, but it didn't look like it from here.
Good patient offense again there by Seattle on their end zone line. Plenty of time after that turnover. Great D there by Alex Duffel to get the disc back. Didn't see it for very long. Left his feet. Got a little piece of it. Strout not able to get it. And Rainmakers march it back up and score to take the lead in the closing seconds of the first half.
That's right. Duffel staying in, of course. As they're doing the prevent defense with 12 seconds left last time ended up with a score for Seattle from Todd Sliva's fantastic D. Moves it all the way over to King on the close sideline. King launches it with 7 seconds left. Isaac Kent, 6'6", is going to go up and show that he's the only Frost Giant around. Pulls it down.
Oh, got the ref there.
As they do a little called play when we're annoyed at the officials. We're going to pull him down. You're going to see that 500 throw.
Looks like the official is okay and will officiate the second half.
That's right. There's no injury, no IR for the officials right now.
And that was just after the fact, the clock had run out. Norden trying to get a little greatest on the D. Doesn't get there. Both teams, solid first half coming off the field. Here you see Isaac Entz going up big against two Portland players trying for it. Nice defense to prevent the tie. And then throws it. And here you'll see Norden trying for the greatest. Nothing there, but then slide tackling the ref is Woodside coming up broadside on the referee.
See, Isaac Entz not looking so big over there against Adamson, but those are two monster players. You put a typical person in the stand out there, you'd realize just how big these guys are and how high that game of 500 is going on.
Some unforced errors here in the first half, but generally even play. Both teams looking sharp. A little rain, a couple drops. We'll see if they can clean it up in the second half. Seattle leading 7-6 at the end of two periods.
That's right. This is the Western Conference game of the week, of course. And as expected, a tight game. The Portland Stags right now on serve. Seattle started on offense, and Portland will start on offense for the second half. They're all on serve. Portland, though, used to just rolling over teams. Every team they've played, they have beaten, except the Rainmakers.
And Seattle crowd here firing up behind their home team, Rainmakers. And a solid first half as we head in to a commercial. Come right back for more MLU action.
Jeff Snader here, Commissioner of Major League Ultimate. 15 years ago, I got out of the Marine Corps, played my first ever game of Ultimate Frisbee with my brother. And now, I find myself immersed in one of the fastest growing team sports in the nation. And here, at beautiful PPL Park in Philadelphia, on July 19th at 6:30 p.m., the largest showcase of our sport will happen with the MLU Championship game. You can get all tickets and information at mluchampionship.com to see the best in the world. I'll see you there. Jeff Snader here, Commissioner of Major League Ultimate. 15 years ago, I got out of the Marine Corps, played my first ever game of Ultimate Frisbee with my brother. And now, I find myself immersed in one of the fastest growing team sports in the nation. And here, at beautiful PPL Park in Philadelphia, on July 19th at 6:30 p.m., the largest showcase of our sport will happen with the MLU Championship game. You can get all tickets and information at MLUChampionship.com to see the best in the world. I'll see you there.
Here we are at halftime of the luau-themed home game for the Rainmakers. Ted Werbel organizing some shenanigans here. Contestants trying to knock over the palm tree and get it through the raindrop as the Portland and Seattle teams taking a break after their tight 7-6 first half. Should be a good second half coming up as the shenanigans continue.
Show you some highlights from that first half so far. As somebody's trying to cheat and help out, push that.
Could be teamwork there, knocking over that palm. Easy one to Strout, who's right there in the end zone between two defenders. Nice little dish from Lori following a good march up from the Stags.
You got Koss moving over to that far sideline. That was Jimmy Chu when they were trapped on the close sideline, and good decision to just push it over to that open space. Miles of room as Chu brings it in.
Generally pretty good end zone O there for the Rainmakers. A lot of patience. And there you see Jimmy Chu, tons of room, tracking it. Reed Koss puts it up in the air for an easy grab from Chu.
No defense to be seen.
Sam Harkness getting every other in one of these points here. Sending that one up to Ants, who launches it. Big flick to El Salam. Goes up early with the right hand. Comes back with the left hand. And pulls out the goal. And then celebrates.
Davis got some height on him. So he decides to trick him. Jump early. Jump off. And it's how we vote in Chicago. It's how we play Ultimate out here in Seattle.
And a good athletic play from a very good athlete, El Salam. It's hard to get up for that second jump. Fired up after that one. Boop.
Salam showing why the Portland Stags should have tried to keep him a little harder. He got sent up, and Mark Burton got sent down.
El Salam, a Seattle native, probably pretty excited to play for his home team Rainmakers.
Here's that unbelievable catch by Rory Gallagher. As you see Todd Sliva just excited. Rory Gallagher flying through the air. He had about 0.4 seconds to see that disc leave his feet. One-handed grab in the rain. Amazingly athletic play by Gallagher.
And here's Rosado. The big floaty flick. El Salam doesn't have position there. And great D by Hayes to bring that one down.
Here you got the best defense we've seen from Tridiac. That's not true. As Tridiac goes up and gets Ferreira, who just starts walking away immediately.
And here in the rain, coming down, Trotter with an easy flick to McKibben, who's gotten a couple goals. Traditionally a handler, fired up by getting some space up the line there in the far corner. Nice shot here from Trotter. Plenty of room for McKibben. No chance for McGinn.
Trotter making those throws, those flicks in the rain look easy. I promise you they are not, as you've seen so many of those flying out and dropping.
And a bladey swing. Rosado can't hang on. Couple of hammers going up. Exciting for the defense there from Tridiac up with Burton. Burton looking to the ref. Why didn't I get that foul call? A good clean D there. There you see one of the flicks just going wobble.
That was one of the highlights of the game, absolutely.
Yeah. A low light for McKibben, but
It does show how hard these normal throws are. I mean, here's Sam Harkness, and these are just a bunch of little throws. Salam moving it over to McKibben. It makes it look real easy. None of those throws are easy. McKibben is screaming. He's so excited to have it in the end zone so he doesn't have to throw it again.
Some flicks going haywire in the first half. Sam Harkness, quick thrower, Sam Harkness. And there you see the other one of McKibben's goals.
You do see those goals from McKibben and from the other handlers. Handlers end up with a fair number of goals just because they're always being guarded as if they're not a threat in the end zone. And they're showing that they are.
Skip Sewell coming over the sandwich to grab that one. Great D from Matt Skip Sewell.
And there's Norton breezing it into Strout.
Good end zone O from both teams. And you will see the handlers getting it a lot in the end zone offense. A lot of movement.
Coming back as these players looking a little more serious as they're throwing around now. In the rain, they realize that that score doesn't have to be 7-6. Either team thinking, you know, they could be up a lot more if they were taking a little better care of the disc, if they'd maybe switched into a rain mentality. One of those games where you got to be patient and take easier, calmer shots. Both of them maybe looking at that score and thinking, we want to do better. Not seeing as many scoobers and hammers going out there. Seeing a lot more just people working on their pivots and their flicks.
A lot of hammers gone up, a lot of hucks gone too far, and then a lot of turnovers from swing passes that have a lot of edge on them. We've seen a lot of those diving and not giving players a chance. That wet disc, it's harder to bring in. So those swings for both teams need to come off a little flatter to make sure that they keep possession. You want to use the width of the field, but when those have too much blade on them, it's really hard to bring them in, and we've seen both teams suffer as a result.
And it's not just possession. If you have to bid for a disc or you have to curl a funny way, it breaks up the flow of the offense. You don't get that quick disc movement. You have to stand up or pivot and get squared up to the downfielders, and that just takes some time.
And we're going to head to commercial here, but join us for the second half in just a moment here in Renton Memorial Stadium.
Jeff Snader here, Commissioner of Major League Ultimate. 15 years ago, I got out of the Marine Corps, played my first ever game of Ultimate Frisbee with my brother. And now, I find myself immersed in one of the fastest growing team sports in the nation. And here, at beautiful PPL Park in Philadelphia, on July 19th at 6:30 p.m., the largest showcase of our sport will happen with the MLU Championship game. You can get all tickets and information at MLUChampionship.com to see the best in the world. I'll see you there.
And welcome back to Renton Memorial Stadium. As you see some folks throwing around, as MLU Live is bringing you the Portland Stags playing the Seattle Rainmakers here in Renton Memorial Stadium. That's the Rainmakers' home team.
It's luau madness here. Fans getting deep into some halftime activities.
And these Major League Ultimate games are streamed on MLU Live thanks to Elemental Technologies. Elemental is a software company based in downtown Portland that specializes in delivering video over the internet to audiences worldwide. The company helps broadcasters and media brands stream video of major sporting events like the Winter Olympics and the upcoming 2014 FIFA World Cup. The company is growing fast and always looking for world-class engineers. You can learn more and check out careers at elementaltechnologies.com.
As the teams here in Renton Memorial Stadium practicing some throws and getting ready for the second half. Set to start here in just under a minute and a half. And anybody's game here coming in. Steve Gusson bringing the team in to the huddle to check. chat about second half strategy. We've seen from both teams a mix of horizontal and vertical stacks. A lot of movement through the handlers.
And you might notice, just as these teams are getting used to the rain, in that close-up, you see it's no longer raining. The disc will still be plenty wet every time it hits that turf. But you could see again the game changing, and these teams have to change their strategies and their mentalities with the weather.
And again, it's just that supreme focus that the wet disc demands for a clean game. And we'll see which one of these teams can clean it up, bring that focus into the second half, and which teams bring the zanier defenses that mix up those plays. And we've seen a couple of big blocks, both in the air, a couple of layout blocks out on the field. Good solid play from both teams.
Absolutely. It's been exciting keeping it close. As these two teams, of course, not only playing for today, but playing for mentality coming into next week when they play each other again, that time down in Portland. And, of course, the Rainmakers have to win this one to be in contention for the title of West Coast champion, to be up there with the West Coast Conference.
And we'll see if we see some added intensity from them and whether they're keeping track of that themselves. I'm sure they are. And they'll want to take advantage here in the second half.
That's right. Portland Stags right now 6-1, having a stellar season so far. Three games left. If they drop all three, they'd be 6-4. Seattle Rainmakers 4-4. This game and another, also against Portland, remaining. If they win both of them, they will also be 6-4. So depending on the surges, depending on the fickle nature of this game, we'll see who ends up on top of the West Coast Conference.
Here you see fans button up, getting ready for the second half of play as the Rainmakers set to pull to the visiting Stags. Usual customers out there for the Rainmakers. Feely set to pull.
Feely with the disc. Todd Sliva, one of those monster defenders who gets the some of the hardest matchups.
And Feely's pull out of bounds. And the Stags will bring the disc up. Norden will center it in what looks to be a horizontal stack for the Stags.
I bet what we're going to see, as usual, is the horizontal stack. Two go deep, and one comes across in that hole.
One goes deep. Handlers move it. Strout back to Norden. Takes the backhand, double team. Over to Strout. A lot of movement downfield, but the disc so far just with the handlers. Kenton moves it over back through the middle to Strout. Norden takes off deep, draws two defenders. Disc stays with the handlers. And now they're in more of a vertical stack. A lot of guys back. Allison Hall bobbled it six times and brings it in and gets the foul call.
He's almost going to get stalled. Gets stalled before he even has possession.
Talk about that focus. That's great focus. Couldn't quite hang on, but Allison Hall bobbles it five or six times, comes up with the disc and some contact. Norden pivots out of bounds, but potentially here a receiver travel, and he'll step back 10 yards and try again. Surveying the field. Vertical stack. Nice bid there from Skip Sewell, but Friedman able to bring it in for the first blood in the second half as the Portland Stags tie it up, and Friedman going for a high five with Allison Hall, reenacting the bobbles.
That's right. I saw them working at that spike a little before when they were thrown around. But you do see those flicks coming off a lot cleaner now that you have that flick from Norden coming off real clean, getting a little above Sewell and down low enough for Friedman. Those flicks coming off a lot cleaner now that that rain has ceased for the time being.
And talking about that focus, that's Allison Hall just making that play his own there and keeping the disc alive for the Stags, who bring it up to a tie game. 8:53 remaining.
I don't know if they keep stats for it, but I think Allison Hall just won for most touches per catch.
I think so.
Yeah.
I'm willing to put money on that one. Stags set to pull here. Go for Davis on the pull. Davis with a big pull. Chris Rupp brings it down to McKibben. Side stack, leaving El Salam wide open on the side. Tridiak open down the line. Gets a fake from El Salam. Over to Tommy Rosado, over to Sam Harkness. Good use of the width there. Harkness puts a little float on it. Makes Rosado look good, getting it up the line. Back to Harkness, back to Rosado. El Salam wants it, gets it. Puts it out in front of Trotter. Goal! Rainmakers.
Rainmakers crowd loving that. Looking very smooth. This is a much cleaner game than we saw at the first half when folks were worried about their throws. Now everyone's pretty confident. Rain ceased. And you see Trotter giving some high fives, getting some hands after that nice shot to him, jumping it in from El Salam.
And nice work on the offensive line. Lots of quick movement across the field. Opens up that side. El Salam gets it. Nice flick out in front for Trotter. Defense doesn't have a chance. And the Rainmakers go back up one, 8-7.
As this is going to be a deep round punching match, as these offenses just duking it out at this point. 1 point, 1 point, 1 point at a time.
Duffel with a pull to the Stags' end zone line. Center to Norden. Horizontal stack, some junky D here from the Rainmakers, mixing up the play. A lot of horizontal movement from the Stags. Strout, Bjorklund, Friedman, Strout. Whistle on the field.
The officials pointing to the far sideline. And they're nobody sure what they're complaining about. So they let play continue.
Just moves into the middle to Bjorklund. Back to Norden. Chasing Seattle defenders. Lots of movement here between the Portland handlers. Strout gets a swing off. Contact on the throw. It'll be Strout's disc upfield.
You'd rather take that 10 yards up rather than the 5 yards back.
Get a new stall count. Friedman gets open off the back against Sewell. Strout finds him in the corner for a nice easy goal. That's a great cut right before the disc was in from Friedman. Showing some savvy and smarts there and getting the goal.
That's what you were talking about before. They're so quick mentally on switching into offense from anything.
Here you'll see Friedman comes off the back, leaves Sewell coming in, and Stroud, as soon as the disc gets checked back in after that foul, sends it up the line for the goal to Friedman. And Friedman and Stroud, having played a few games together over the years, long-time Ultimate players together out of Portland.
That's
Strout,
right.
We've seen looking for Friedman a couple times too long on the deep shots there. Gives him some nice space for the goal.
You see not only that quick transition on the Stags to bring it in and kind of beat them on the first mental step, but also both teams playing defense like they still have the rain helping them. Both teams kind of putting those hard force flicks on and hoping that these throws aren't going to be so precise, but now they are.
And guys getting open downfield, not putting a ton of challenge on, and it looks like now maybe ran out of time on the pull.
We're not getting any signals from the officials quite yet as John Ladd starts telling the Stags where to go. It's going to be offset by 20 yards. Looks like that's either too much time on the pull or an offsides call. So the whole field gets shifted 20 yards. And you'll see the Stags pulling from the back of their end zone and the Rainmakers sitting on the 20-yard line way out in front of theirs.
So the Rainmakers already gaining some yards in this point. We'll see if the Stags defenders can rise to the challenge. Pulling it at the very back of the end zone. And a big floaty pull will give the Rainmakers even more yardage. Rainmakers with less than half of the field to cover. Score. Looks like they're setting up in a horizontal stack with McKibben bringing the disc against a man defense.
Only 30 yards out.
Play we've seen before. Two guys clear space. There's El Salam bringing it in the sideline. Smartly moving it off the sideline. Good swing. McKibben. Koss. A little bit more messy now in the horizontal stack. Tridiak gets open under. Finds Koss, but great D. And the shutdown from Ferreira.
Ferreira coming through real quick. Leaves his feet quickly to stop Koss from getting it.
Davis with it on the other side. Nice bid from El Salam, but can't get there as Hayes hangs on. Resets to McGinn. McGinn centers to Davis. Over to Thornton. Thornton over to McGinn. Almost sneaking up the back there was Rupp, but not able to disrupt that play. Cole moves it across. And Stags, not sure if this is a, it looks like a horizontal stack, but leaving themselves a lot of options. They're not really holding to form. And there is a bobble.
That was a D.
Wanted a call.
That was a D by Elliot Trotter. Trotter got a hand around the back and in between the hands. That was just a little whack-a-mole. He thought he was going to get that disc in his hand, and the mole pops out from right around his side.
And Thornton looked to the ref. Not sure what happened there, but Seattle giving it back. A little sloppy play here, but the Stags bringing it back in. Again, turfs it.
That was about four turnovers in 12 seconds.
It was clean up until then in this here in this second half, and now neither team wanting to hang on too long to this disc.
Seems like the offense saw those defensive shots and thought, oh, the D's doing too well. Let's just try something funky. Sometimes you can get scared of defenders, and you start thinking that people aren't open when, you know, 5 minutes ago they were. And so you decide to do something with the throw instead of with the legs.
Koss bringing it in with a vertical stack for the Rainmakers. And whistle on the play. Looked like contact on Koss's pivot. And the ref agrees. Koss will take 10 yards to bring it in. The fans getting in, asking their guys to make it rain. Koss with the disc. Vertical stack in motion. Tridiak gets it out to the side. McKibben takes off deep, but well guarded. They'll reset to Koss. Rupp. Toss rep. Up the line, McKibben. Familiar faces around the disc here for Seattle. Up the line to El Salam. Tridiak puts his hand up and calls for it. El Salam honors it. Tridiak misses his chance for that one. The shadow block.
That was a trust call, but that hand got in his eyes. And wasn't able to find the disc.
It's good D there by Davis. Didn't get a piece of it, but got up in front of Tridiak so he couldn't see it. And the disc goes right by.
As Davis is going to have to put on an armband.
He might have had something to say after the play there, not sure.
The play looks clean. Not sure if the words were afterwards. And he's going to have to wear the red badge of shame.
But getting some high fives. A good defensive play there by Davis, despite what he might have had to say. It was picked up by the ref after the play. Tridiak, the one most frustrated there, called for it. El Salam puts up a shot that Davis couldn't get. But then neither could Tridiak.
The timeout called as you see some new players taking the field.
Here you see El Salam with it on the sideline. Puts a flick up. Davis tries to get there. Tridiak has a chance but couldn't get his hand on it with Davis in the way. And a turnover for Seattle with the Portland Stags bringing it back in here after the timeout into a horizontal stack.
Didn't look like any words exchanged there between Tridiak and Davis. Not sure why he has to wear the armband.
That's between the referees and Davis himself, I guess.
Really wide horizontal stack coming from the Stags. Not sure if they have a set play. But it looks like Kenton coming in with the disc as Kalmakis.
Kalmakis doing some disruptive calisthenics here. Disc is in. Very active double team. Dump goes to Norden. Cross field to Strout, wide open. Good pressure defense, though. Bjorklund gets it. Allison Hall takes off deep, but the defender goes with him as it moves up. Good quick movement from the Stags. No one hanging on to it too long. Friedman sees Bjorklund upfield. Bjorklund kind of stutter steps, but gets body in front, gets position, and gets the goal.
Bjorklund there, I'm not sure if that was a stutter step or if he was purposely just positioning that wide frame to get in front of Gallagher to make sure that Gallagher didn't have a play at the disc.
And good body position there, and a nice throw from Friedman. Puts it out in front and allows Bjorklund to have time to position his body in front. Not giving Gallagher a chance. Here you see Friedman floating it up. Nice hanging shot. Bjorklund holding position the whole time. Gallagher trying to sneak around. But Bjorklund showing why he's one of the keys to this Portland team.
Great hip control from Bjorklund. Really controlling the hips of the defender. Making sure that he knows where the defender wants to go. And he prevents the defender from getting there.
Rory Gallagher tries to make a play on it, but not so much. 9-8 Portland.
That was a breakup for Portland. Taking the lead, even though Seattle started with the disc on this one.
And Armband Davis send up the pull. Still a very close game here with 4:30 remaining in the third. Centers to McKibben. Horizontal stack. The swing goes by a couple guys and over to Rosado. Not sure who the intended receiver there was, but let's pretend it was Rosado. El Salam resets to Rupp, who is totally stranded. But Trotter wide open in the middle. Over to Tridiak, over the side to McKibben. Back to Rupp. A funky offense here, quite spread out for Seattle, but they're finding openings.
Seattle moving the disc just as fast as Portland was last time, but Seattle's all lateral movement, not gaining a lot of yards here.
Rosado. McKibben Rosado. Up to Tridiak. Make sure to bring that one in. Throws from the ground to McKibben. McKibben puts it out in front of El Salam. Salam, a fan favorite because he loves scoring and lets folks know. Celebrating.
Loves hearing that crowd.
And a nice play there. Good shot out in front from McKibben to El Salam. Soaking up the Seattle love.
A little extra love for Salam here in Rent Memorial as he is one of the Seattle youth. He is one of the younger players in the MLU. Came out of Seattle high schools, came out of Seattle middle schools. And the folks just love to see him get these discs. Here's McKibben shooting it deep. The crowd starts yelling before he's even brought it in because he's so open and they know what's going to happen.
And he makes sure the crowd knows that he got that goal. And a good play there from Tridiak. You don't usually advise your players to throw from their knees or sitting on the ground, but there Tridiak slides down to make sure he gets it in. Feeds it to McKibben running upfield. McKibben with a nice view of the field as El Salam gets open off the back. And Seattle tying it up and sending a roller pull off the side. A little past half field.
That was Alex Duffel, one of the few guys in the game who pulls with a forehand.
Nice double team on the sideline. Norton able to get off the dump. Nice swing out to Strout. Seattle defensive chasing. Friedman finds a gap. Almost gives Schneider a chance. Strout moves it over to Kenton, who looks deep. A nice bid, but Allison Hall able to hang on.
That's the second or third time I've seen Todd Sliva make a fantastic help D bid, but 0-for-2, 0-for-3 right now.
And Allison Hall, good focus there, not letting the shadow block occur and bringing it in.
I'm sorry, that was not Todd Sliva. That was Ben Beener going for that defense. As you see right here, Beener.
Couple of flailing rainmakers, but a nice shot there. Allison Hall bringing it in. Allison Hall, of course, proving his focus by bobbling it to himself about six times earlier today. As the Stags get set to bring down the defense with a one-point lead with about 3.5 minutes here remaining in the third.
Allison Hall, one of the monsters on the Stags. He's just such a big target. It's got to be so tempting when you see him going deep. He has a couple steps, and you think even if this throw isn't perfect, he's probably going to come down with it.
Exactly what happened there. Making some exciting play there with some rainmakers attempting to get that, but a good enough throw that makes it all the way in. Rainmakers bring it in, center. Very deep horizontal stack. Koss adjusts his cut. Gets it up the middle. Jimmy Chu very deep. Too deep to throw to there. Koss, a nice inside out across to El Salam. El Salon back to Koss. Kidman wide open deep. They look to the other side to Chu, and a nice shot out in front. Jimmy Chu bringing it in again with his left hand. Nice throw. And the catch by Jimmy Chu. Rainmakers tied up at 10s.
Beautiful shot there. Jimmy Chu had some yards, and there is a big window, but it's tough to put it there in a place Chu can really find and make an easy catch. You got to not just get the disc there, but get it there early, get it there coming from the side so it's not coming straight over his head. And a beautiful shot there by Koss.
There you see it floating out in front. Davis is chasing, but Chu, plenty of space. A couple of deep cutters open there. McKibben was open on the other side. Chu was open on that side. Koss finds it for the nice flick.
Game tied up. No team been ahead by more than two, that lead when Portland was up 2-0. Since then, it's always been within one for the rest of the game.
Keeping it exciting, which the crowd here in Renton loves, and you got to love there at home, watching these two big Northwest teams going at it here. Norden moves it across. Friedman with it. Easy shot up the sideline. Allison Hall. Bjorklund going deep. Looks him off. Would look to swing it. There's a scoober up to Friedman. And Strout coming to that same sideline. They're really milking that flick sideline. Bjorklund finding Norden off the back. Might as well send it back up that same sideline. There's Bjorklund again. There's Norden. Let's see if they can get a swing off this time. There it is. Into the middle.
Finally gets it all the way around.
Kenton, Allison Hall. Allison Hall reaching out in front. And a great diving grab by Strout.
Ben Beener coming off a little frustrated. It looks like he was on the mark there and got a hand on it, but you can't stop Strout in the end zone.
When those big swings go off, it's hard to shut down the break continue passes. The Seattle defense keeping them on the flick sideline most of that point, but as soon as they were able to get a swing off, there were continues. And as you see here, Norden able to find that swing over to Kenton. Kenton over to Allison Hall. Allison Hall leaves a scary one out, but Strout supermans it for the goal. Superman that goal.
He went almost all the way out to the track. Gets up, and unless the defense tried to put another break on the goal on the field.
And Portland leading these latest trades in points. Going up one. Seattle's been coming back to tie it up each time here for the most part in the third period. And now see if there's any shift to that or if Seattle can keep it going.
Seattle offense got to get this point in to get their D on the field. They're still down a break, and they need one to be able to get this game in their hands.
Given up to Tridiak. Tridiak launches a flick. There's Sam Harkness. The long legs of Sam Harkness keeping it in the back of the end zone, and a quick goal for the Rainmakers.
Harkness pulls it in with about one step to go. Not even really looking at his feet, just runs, grabs it in stride, and the officials call him in for the quick response by Seattle.
We've seen a lot of hucks go too far today. That one giving Sam Harkness plenty of room to run onto. Barely enough room in the back of the end zone, but barely is enough, as Seattle able to tie it up with just over 2 minutes remaining in the third period of play.
Here you're going to see that shot from Tridiak. Giant flick. He can throw it as far as he wants. The question is it too far? And you see it was just that 1 foot that was still in from Harkness. As if that came off the ground, he's out of bounds.
Sam Harkness tracking it down quite well. 11-11.
Eddie Feely coming on, playing that defensive general. As you see the usual defensive suspects out there, Todd Sliva and Rory Gallagher on the left. Feely comes up with the pull.
Big pull coming down to the Stags. Moving in to what looks like a horizontal stack. Centers to Norden. Both teams pretty comfortable moving it between their handlers here. Disc centers to Friedman. Allison Hall wide open on the sideline, as Todd Sliva comes over and finds him for the mark. Allison Hall looks upfield and then resets to the handlers. Good adjustment here by the cutters, moving back towards the handlers.
Shot going up to Allison Hall as Sliva is going to be chasing.
Allison Hall, great positioning there, shakes the defender and gets the goal. A nice shot downfield from Kenton.
Sliva hurrying up to get there, but by the time he gets there, he realizes the disc is still far too high and just continues running out of bounds, realizing he can't stop on that dime and take a left. The way Hall can just walk over and catch it.
Allison Hall with nice position there, bodying him out, and then making a move on the disc at the end. Allison Hall having quite a game here today.
One of those really big guys. You saw Sliva guarding him initially.
Here you see the replay. Kenton launching a flick up. And there you see Allison Hall getting good position on Sliva. Sliva not able to track the disc, and Allison Hall a little shake and bake at the end there for the easy goal for Portland, going up 12-11 with 1:45 remaining in the third.
Hall on that one, he was the one who was wide open on the near to the screen, and just from that position took off all the way across the field. Lots of room to run, lots of time to get going real fast.
Rainmakers bring it down, under 2 minutes remaining. McKibben surveys the field, finds Koss in the middle. El Salam open. Koss hacked on the mark. And will take the 10 yards to bring it back in. Horizontal stack. Tridiak, shake and bait, gets open deep. Koss sees him right away, puts it out in front. Goal, Rainmakers. And a great move by Danny Tridiak to get open deep.
Just like what happened with Norton in the second quarter. Before that disc was really even in, before anybody was set up, Tridiak was always already starting to make his move, and made it.
The move worked. It was the old fake in, go out, left his defender behind him. Here you see Koss sees him, puts it out in front, and Tridiak had steps the whole way as Davis was chasing, but Tridiak with a little juke move got himself open for the goal. Boom.
Tridiak, always good for those surprising 40-yard sprints. He moves awfully quick for who's usually a defensive cutter or sometimes kind of a second out of a play. But his long game is plenty good.
And when that disc is up in there, he really wants to get it. Portland Stags coming back with just over a minute remaining. Tie game, 12-12. Seattle would love to get their break here. A little contact on the mark, and Brooklyn will limp upfield 10 yards. Maybe got a Charlie horse there, not sure.
After watching all this soccer, I tend not to trust it. He started walking forward before the officials called anything, but they're going to agree with him.
Moves it in the middle. There's Norton. Allison Hall again, open deep. Norton finds him for an easy flick. I think he got to guard Allison Hall here.
You know, they've been putting Todd Sleeve and Ben Beener on him. Both of them initially starting well behind him, but then they kind of start creeping up, and he blows past and gets too open, too deep.
And that's a nice move by him. Again, little cut at his defender, faking in, going out. Norton loves any excuse to launch a flick. Had a good excuse there with Allison Hall wide open deep.
45 seconds remaining in this quarter, and a chance for somebody to actually show a defensive play. Show some defense and maybe a break.
There's Norton making sure he has it. Sees Allison Hall get open. Beener chasing. Not going to get there. Goal Stags going up 13-12 with about 45 seconds remaining. You see Norton just launching it. Beener 10 steps behind. Maybe not 10 steps, but steps.
Steps behind is Bjorklund and Beener chasing behind. Good hustle by both of them. You never know what'll happen, but with Allison Hall, what happened is he catches it.
He's got padding his stats here today. Rainmakers march it back up with 40 seconds remaining. Trotter with the disc. Nice swing. Out to Rosado. To El Salam. Moves it back to an open Chris Rupp in the middle. Lots of cuts for the Rainmakers. McKibben. El Salam approaching the end zone here. Al-Salam, nice pivoting. Moves it to Tridiak. Finds Rupp.
Not a lot of definitive, decisive cutting out here by the downfielder.
And a stall, great switch off of the stack to come to the cutting handler defender, forcing the stall. That's nice team defense from the Stags, who will get a chance with 1 second left, and not a chance. A little bit more clock awareness from them. Could have had a chance, but good job by Portland putting a stop to Seattle's attack to close out this third period of play and keep the one-point lead.
That's exactly what happened. Those downfield cutters were not being very decisive, which allowed the defenders to really get a look at the field and make that critical switch at about stall five, leaving 2 seconds with no throws, and Rupp gets stalled out there.
And if I were Seattle's coach, I would come down on Danny Tridiak to move that disc more quickly. He got the swing towards the middle of the field. Chris Rupp was open for another 10 or 12-yard swing. Tridiak, having it in a powerful position in the middle of the field, but looking off that open man, stagnated their offense and allowed Portland's defense to come and disrupt their end zone out.
That's right. That's what you were talking about, the Stags doing so well that a couple points ago when they were trapped on that far sideline. It was about 10-10 at that point. So far, they've been trading. Now Portland up 13-12 at the end of the third quarter. Trapped on that far sideline, and you called it. Once they got it off that sideline and swung it all the way over to the close sideline, they were able to put it in.
The swing, a valuable tool in ultimate. Moving that disc horizontally puts a lot more pressure on the defense, who has to track it. And we'll take a short break and come back for the exciting fourth quarter finish. Seattle versus Portland.
See the
Welcome back as we get set in just a minute here to finish out with the fourth quarter play in this tightly contested match between the Portland Stags and Seattle's home team Rainmakers here live from Renton Memorial Stadium.
What we need to see out of both teams, but especially out of the Stags, especially out of the Rainmakers, is some pressure on D. So far, the offense has really been controlling that last quarter. There were no breaks. There weren't even really many chances for breaks. And if Seattle wants to get ahead at all, they're going to have to get that disc in the defense hands.
A lot of open swings and a bit better job by both teams keeping those flat throws, allowing the swings to be easily caught. A little bit cleaner from both offenses here. And should be an exciting fourth quarter. We'll see which team brings it on D to try and disrupt the other team's offense. Portland starting with the pull. Here's Davis to start us off. Fourth quarter play. Portland up one, 13-12, as the Rainmakers initiate their offense. Trotter to McKibben. Man defense. Back over to Trotter. Man defense, but no, it looks like a 1-3-3, actually.
1-3-3 looks like, or maybe even a 1-2-2-1.
It's some good awareness from the defense, disrupting a couple passes. Toss now with it, finds an opening. Nice find to El Salam. If they can keep moving, the defense won't have a chance to catch up. El Salam up to Trotter. Trotter finds El Salam, but the defender shaking the ref, but then Rosado bringing it in and launching himself onto the mat.
Rosado with a nice read there. Instead of going up for the disc with El Salam, he decides to play junk, and it works that time. He becomes the trash man, picks up the garbage there.
And I don't think Trotter saw the other pair of guys downfield and was just looking for the open El Salam. Let's take a look. Trotter looking upfield. You see El Salam is open, but coming off of the backside is the Portland Stags D. Looks like Woodside. And then Rosado getting the deflection, letting it go, and launching himself. And a little bit tricky there that Woodside caught up by the referee there, but did get a piece of that D. Not enough to keep Rosado from getting it. Goal Rainmakers. 13-all as the Rainmakers send the pole all the way down the field. Strout centers to Norton. Quickly over to Kenton. Upfield to Friedman, resets. Good saggy D by the Rainmakers. Force the hammer over the top. Allison Hall on the far side. Flip into the middle. There's Lori. Over to Strout. Back to Norton. Over to Bjorklund on the side. Lori tries to make a move downfield. Doesn't quite get open enough. Disc resets to Norton. Rifles a flick up to Lori. Good movement here from the Portland Stags. Quickly moving it through their offense, through the handlers, and into the middle as they can. Disc now with Friedman on the forehand side. Reset to Norton. Some contact. Inadvertent, but certainly contact nonetheless.
As it looks like.
With the ref calling, I think, perhaps a receiving travel. Or maybe contact on Norton. Norton launches one up to Friedman. Friedman shielding his defender. Shakes him and finds Lori for the goal. Nice play by Friedman, bringing it down.
Lori scored that one, but once again, that's one of those plays where before the disc was brought in, those cutters start up, and that's how Friedman got so open on Alex Duffel. Duffel still watching the disc, waiting for the disc to come in, and Friedman saying, you know, we don't have to wait for the disc. We can go now.
And you see the disc is checked in, and almost immediately, Norton's able to launch one up. Friedman tracking it well. Duffel chasing, not able to get position. Friedman with some nice pivoting and faking. Duffel trying to make a hero block on the end zone line, but opens up the backhand for Friedman to hit Lori. And Portland, again, out in front by one.
You see, Friedman left so early on that Norton had to really rocket it there, and Duffel actually had a chance. Nice hero wall attempt, but it does open up that backhand, and Lori can bring it down. 14-13 Portland.
8:10 remaining, 8:09 remaining here in the fourth period. Seattle fans getting into it. Rupp brings it down. Centers to McKibben. Swinging it over to Rosado, who fires it back over to Rupp.
A little no look.
Good junk D here from the Stags, forcing Seattle to really have to find their openings. McKibben sends a little flip backhand up the sideline, gets it back. Centers to Tridiak, directly into the center to Sam Harkness
as Portland transitions into man.
Rupp slips, but his throw makes it to McKibben, back to Rupp. Kind of a vertical stack here. El Salam getting a lot of openings here today. Catches, turns, finds Elliot Trotter, who trots on into the end zone for the Rainmakers' goal, and the fans are loving it.
Trotter, not one of the tallest players on the field, but he certainly plays tall, and almost everybody who's ever played with him, including all the Stags, know that. No harm to put it up to Trotter. He will get up, get over that line, and get in.
Here you see Rupp sending the flick up to El Salam, who turns and guns. And Elliot Trotter gets up, protecting himself into the end zone. And Thornton can't get there. Trotter, steel-eyed and stone-faced celebration.
Ooh. Does a good job there getting his hips behind him to stop Thornton from being able to make a play on the disc, kind of like Bjorklund was doing before against Rory Gallagher.
Certainly good position there. Seattle going to need a break in this period to pull out the win. Portland receives. Norton with it. Now Seattle with a bit of a junky D. Put some pressure on, but finding Lori on the sideline. Norton gets it back. Lori, good quick movement. Bjorklund trying not to let these Seattle defenders set up.
Seattle defense in what looks like a clam.
Leaving Norton open. Norton tries for the give and go. Bjorklund instead.
And Seattle transitions
Lori
into man.
Lori, Strout. Nice bid. Not able to get there. Bjorklund gets it. Norton now. Kenton with an inside-out flip finds Lori. Exciting D there from Beener, but that throw did not go up. Portland in their end zone set. Bjorklund finds Kenton. Norden trying to set up their offense, running through the handlers until their cutters get set up. There's Norden. Two cuts off the side. One breaks it off. And the other scores. Lori, a lot of touches that point. A lot of throws that point. Good patience by Portland's offense. Good pressure from Seattle, but steadfast O from Portland.
Still got to love that red line defense from Seattle, even though it does end with this little shot to that corner where Lori's screaming out and Beener and Feely just kind of chasing behind. But until then, really about 20 throws in the red zone. Great stand by Seattle. Portland just outpaces them and puts it into Lori in that close corner.
And Portland up one again, 15-14, with just over 6 minutes remaining here in the game.
Right now, Seattle's got to be thinking, if we can't put something in, we've just got to time it so that it ends in a tie and we can go into overtime, get that little disc flip. But that defense, you know, if they get a break, they could be winning it right here, put it away, and have some confidence going into that next match next week.
Of course, Portland looking for a break as well to try and seal this one up. Anything can happen here with 6 minutes remaining. Rupp centers to Koss. Again, a bit of a junky defense, kind of a diamond D. Rupp, little catch and go to El Salam, resets to Koss. Kibben takes off. Been loving scoring so far, looking deep. There's Rupp, finds Tridiak. El Salam off the back. Tridiak takes the easy shot over to Trotter. El Salam open again. And this time Trotter finds him. El Salam loves to score.
And do little celebration dances. And one of the Seattle youth, the home crowd, loves to watch him score. You hear him getting loud here. For Seattle, as they tie it up at 15s. 5 minutes, 43 seconds left on the clock.
Here you see throw go up from Tridiak, who looked El Salam off, takes the easier pass. Trotter finds El Salam. El Salam tracking that into the corner. Does a little dance. And I will say, I have seen El Salam dance, and he can dance.
Every time, he's just practicing these end zone moves.
Yeah. Put the music on, or just put the disc out in front of him. You're going to get a little dance.
Real nice throw there by Trotter. Puts it in so Salam doesn't really have to watch the line, but has tons of room. He can adjust. He can run onto it. Makes it look real easy.
And El Salam getting real open on a lot of cuts here today. A lot of touches downfield for him. Seattle will try and get their first break of the period. The fans want to see it. Cohesive cheer from Seattle fans. They bring that junkie D again. We saw Portland with a lot of patience last point. They had it on offense. Just goes to Norden. Up to Friedman. And the focus of the D is not so much on the mark, but on those next cuts. Trying to send it back through the handlers and put some pressure on the Stags, leaving the dump open.
His defense is almost looking for bad decisions by the offense. You can't really see who's covering whom and hoping to float something into an easy defensive pounce.
King and Friedman. Little give and go. Find Lori. Back to Friedman. You're going to want to guard him. Bjorklund finds it. Good advancement there from Portland, and now they find some patience again. If they can maintain this patience, it should be another easy goal for them. Lots of little give and goes. Oh! And Sam Harkness doesn't fall for the fake. Norden thought he had an easy high backhand, and Sharkness says, nope! Great D from Seattle, and they'll probably bring in their O team to try and solidify this break here.
Fantastic D by Harkness there. Harkness, kind of a known springy player, gets real bouncy there, jumps up, and the disc ends up hitting him in about the bicep.
Norden thought he had him faked out. He's going to put the high backhand over him, but that was not going to happen. Let's take another look. Here you see a lot of give and goes. Norden throws a fake. Sam Harkness kind of gets on his heels, but then jumps up and shuts it down.
Yeah, as Harkness didn't jump on that first fake, which is what Norden was counting on, he's going to jump, and as he's coming down, just toss it over him.
Pretty fired up after that one. And Seattle will have a chance for the break.
As out there, we've seen Ted Warbel looking around, making it hard for anyone on the field to hear anything, as he's debating where to throw a disc and letting some kids dance with pom-poms up in front.
Always a good choice to let kids dance with pom-poms in front.
Oh, day in, day out. It is a lively place here in Renton Memorial with MC Ted Warbel at the mic.
And the fans are into it. The last time they pull, when Seattle pulls, they'll do the rain drop, and they were in perfect unison. A choir director couldn't have had them doing it better out here.
Made the band teacher proud. As Seattle's putting on their offensive line. And, of course, Stags respond with their defense. 15-15, less than 5 minutes remaining in the game. And Seattle hoping to put this up so that these back-and-forth bouts are tied with them ahead rather than constantly Portland advantage.
And we're certainly seeing a lineup here from Portland that has a few guys who play on both sides of the disc. So looks like they're hoping to get that D and come on back. Seattle fans cheering on their team. Reed Koss will bring it in towards the end zone line. McKibben, nice little shake move up the line. Portland, some close man defense. El Salam open again. Downfield, Trotter open, but El Salam already looking to swing it. Goes up to Koss. Over to an open rup. And now Seattle could certainly use some patience. A little zinger of an inside-out backhand to Koss. Koss finds Trotter. Trotter over to Rupp. Good movement up to Rosado. Back to Rupp, but no! Disrupted there by Cole. Great D in the lane. Seattle moving the disc quickly, but Cole shuts it down, and Portland will get another chance at this one. Moves up to Bjorklund. Bjorklund launches one. Rupp chasing it down. Great D on the sideline. Nice D from Chris Rupp.
That was Cole who had gotten that amazing D just a second ago as Rupp brings it back. 3:35 left, and like you said, they put some players who are effective on both sides of the disc. Bjorklund, of course, one of the offensive rocks for the Stags. And once that turn happens, you have Bjorklund to get that disc right away. Good shot at a goal there, but broken up by Rupp.
And an exciting matchup. Two Ds from that matchup as the disc goes over to Rupp with Cole on him. A couple great blocks from both of those guys as Seattle bringing the disc back. There's Koss with it. El Salam open. Not that surprising. El Salam with a flick out. Oh, but no, shut down by Davis. Davis tracking that the whole time, coming from behind the disc. El Salam telegraphing it a little too long. Bjorklund takes two defenders deep with him. Allison Hall with the disc. Finds Laurie on the side. Laurie for an open Friedman. This looks like trouble for Seattle. Friedman fires it in to Bjorklund. And Portland with the quick strike after a nice Davis block goes up one again. 16-15. Well played there by the Stags.
Fantastic Ds from Cole and from Davis. Both of those coming from behind. That's almost an impossible thing to see as an offensive player when you're throwing it side to side and you have somebody come from behind and shoot it in.
Laurie finds Friedman upfield with a lot of room by the end zone. Friedman doesn't waste any time. Rockets it into Bjorklund. Open in the corner. And that's good heads-up defense by Davis to bring that one in after we saw back-to-back exciting blocks from Cole and then Rupp. And then El Salam just holding on to that disc a little too long, not seeing the defender behind him, which is very hard to see. And the Stags retain possession and their one-point advantage.
That is great offense, you know, by Seattle. They're moving the disc quickly. That was great offensive movement. It was almost so bread and butter ultimate that the defense could read what was going to happen next. This is going to be a give and go. This is going to be a little upline shot.
El Salam was looking at his receiver there on that flick and just kept looking. Davis comes up from behind and gets it. Now Seattle with the disc, down one, 2:30 remaining. Disc moves over to Trotter. Some fakes back to Koss. And it's open on that side. Ends up to an open El Salam. Sam Harkness gets open deep, but there's two cutters there. El Salam wisely holds on. Trotter keeps possession. Seattle might want to calm it down a little bit. Koss, rather not. Send it up to El Salam in the end zone. He's probably going to want to get this, but great D from, looks like, Hayes coming up over. Get a little wide-eyed with Seattle. And with 2 minutes remaining, Friedman will get the disc for the Stags with a chance to go up two. which would make this very difficult comeback here with less than 2 minutes for Seattle. And Stags will call a timeout.
The Stags, of course, know Khalif Al-Salam well. He played for them last year. And wise to take a big player like Hayes, who's got several inches on Al-Salam, but they know Khalif Al-Salam plays taller than he is. Put somebody big on him and make sure that he's got a challenge in the air there.
Koss sent it up to Al-Salam, got a little wide-eyed. The crowd, of course, would have gone ballistic had Al-Salam brought it down. But instead, Portland with a chance to pad their lead here with just under 2 minutes.
That's right. If Portland puts this one up 17-15, that really means quite a bit. One, real hard for Seattle to dig out of that. And two, if Seattle can't dig out of it, that will pretty much seal the Western Conference going to Portland if they pull it up to 7-1 as their record for the first 8 games.
Anything could still happen here, though, certainly. One, just under 2 minutes remaining. Portland Stags with this. And the crowd on their feet here at Renton Memorial Stadium to cheer on their Rainmakers. The crowd and the Rainmakers would love to see a block here on this point as the D sets up and Portland brings in the dip.
D going man, Portland Stags in a horizontal, very spread offense, probably with a set play.
The disc is in. Good handler defense there by Feely. Norden gets open. Bjorklund has to flap on the ground to save it. Back to Norden. And here's a good matchup for Eddie Feely. Norden gets the disc a lot for the Stags. Friedman with it out on the sideline. Laurie gets open. Friedman puts it out in front a little too far. And Seattle will have another chance at this one with 1:30 remaining. Harkness wisely brings it in quickly. They have a deficit to make up here. Sends it to Feely. Over to Koss. Harkness open. Al-Salam turns the corner, goes deep. Rory Gallagher wide open underneath. Seattle could use a deep breath here. And it looks like Coach Steve Gussin and assistant coach Mario O'Brien will give them just that.
Not sure why you'd call a timeout there, really. There's 1:09 left. This is a must-score situation. And it seemed to me that the Seattle offense was looking under control right there.
I think a deep breath is a good idea. I think those guys are pretty fired up, and letting them cool out a little bit and run a set offense might behoove them. They were doing a good job of swinging it, but perhaps the coach is just getting a little nervous and wanting to let them talk about it a bit.
Now, I don't know what you do strategy-wise here. I think what you do is if there's an open player, hit it. If you can score, score. But with 1:09 left, it's a little nerve-wracking to tie it up and give 30, 40 seconds to Portland to give them a chance to take it away at the very end of the game.
And you see Portland's assistant coach here coming off and leaving the Stags to chat about it on the field as they discuss their defense. With just over 1 minute left, this game is exciting. And the fans feeling it.
Fans getting loud. Hundreds of them out there, ready for the last minute of the game. Unless Seattle manages to put it in and put a stop to Portland, in which case we could get some bonus time going into overtime.
Here's a horizontal stack that is not spread to the very sidelines. It's sort of an angled horizontal stack as Koss set to bring it in. Al-Salam a little deep in the horizontal stack. I wouldn't be surprised to see him coming under if Harkness and Rosado clear space downfield, which is all happening just to the right of your screen.
You saw Gavin McKibben close to us, making sure that McGinn stays on him.
Koss finds Harkness. Harkness back to Koss. And the offense is underway here. Tridiak coming across. Harkness. Cole coming off the back, looking to get that block from off of the man. Doesn't get there. Tridiak has it right in front of the end zone. But a great D from the Stags defender right on the end zone line. And he goes down.
Tommy Rosado makes a bid himself, but isn't able to pass. Not sure who that is on the far sideline there. Great D bid by the Stags, being helped up right now by Davis. And that looks like that might be Cable on the far sideline.
Sharpness Gets it up to Tridiac. Tridiac sees Rosado going, puts it out in front. But a great D from the Stags defender there. Goes down hard, but gets all of that disc with him.
I'm sorry, that was a Woodside.
Comes off the field.
Woodside, big fella, lands on his shoulder. And is a little frustrated with that right shoulder.
47 seconds remaining. Seattle in a must stop situation. Let's see some exciting D here as Portland brings it in on the sideline. Davis with it. Good pressure from Seattle. Inside out, flick into nowhere, but they recover. Move it over and launch one. Reed Koss, very speedy, but can't get there. As Hayes brings it in right in front of the end zone, Koss with a little bit of an aggressive mark takes down Hayes right on the end zone line.
Not on purpose there by Koss, but as both of them start turning around, Koss tries to come around and hooks an arm.
And with just over 30 seconds remaining, Portland looking to score this and potentially seal the game by going up two. Seattle needing to get a stop. The throw goes out in front to Cole. Cole brings it in, and Portland takes the first two-point lead since they had it at 2-0, putting Seattle in a very tough position with just under 30 seconds remaining.
That might be the nail in the coffin. 20 seconds remain. Seattle, no problem putting it in, but they'll have to put it in, get a stop, put it in again just to go into overtime. That's going to be real tough.
There you see the goal. Cole out in front. Feely not able to get there as the Stags go up two late in this game. Seattle will need to score quickly and then score quickly again if they have a shot to send this into overtime. Portland Stags likely to leave a couple guys deep here. I would expect to see a huck play coming from the Rainmakers.
That's right. You see the typical Rainmakers offense, but a couple key substitutions. For one, Isaac Kent, 6'6" man, coming in probably for the game of 500 that's about to happen.
Center goes to Trotter. Trotter, Koss. Koss has a big flick. Big backhand, too. Launches it to Entz. Entz has position. Brings it in for the goal with 18 seconds. That's what Seattle needed. Let's see if they can bring it on D. Entz fired up. They brought him in, and he makes them proud of that. Bringing it down, a big one from Koss. Good offense from the Rainmakers, and the crowd's still into it.
That is a cornbread man right there. Isaac Entz pulled in for that play, for exactly what he needed to do. We got a weapon. We got a 6'6" monster who can get up, and you'll see this shot coming from Koss. Koss just waiting. The only person streaking deep there is Isaac Entz. Isaac Entz has to box out, which he does, and comes down with it over Adamson.
Adamson, a good attempt there, but hard to get around the big body of Isaac Entz. Entz fired up. Good position. Great grab.
Hoping to close out the second half the same way they closed out the first, where there were just a handful of seconds on the clock. They pulled it. Sliva came through and got a D, and then Gallagher had that insane Superman catch right in the end zone in front of Sliva.
And Portland, all they really need to do is get two passes off to run this clock out. But Seattle going to do everything they can to prevent that. Seattle fans going to do everything they can. They're on their feet here. The pull goes out the sideline. A smart play from Seattle. They will have every opportunity to stop any passes from Portland.
They can't just play prevent here, though, because that leaves too much ability for Portland to run out the clock.
Leaving Bjorklund open on the side. Double team comes. Little piece of it. The D. Just under 10 seconds remaining. This moves over to Koss. Koss launches a flick. El Salam with it. 3 seconds remaining. Turfs it in front of the end zone. El Salam going to be thinking about that one. Seattle had a perfect opportunity to tie the game. And the disc goes into the ground. And the Portland Stags come away with the win. Wow.
We see Todd Sliva head on the floor. That was unbelievable. The D comes through. They have 10 seconds left. Shoots it up. Wise decision that Koss doesn't just rock it into the end zone. He moves it up. Moves it up to the home favorite, El Salam, who
El
then
Salam
just turfs it.
Going to be thinking about that one tonight as the Portland Stags. Here we'll take another look just after we see some high fives from these Northwest competitors. Here you see that D from Sam Harkness. Good pressure from Seattle. That's exactly what they needed. Quick movement, Feely. over to Koss. Koss could send it into the end zone here, but blades it up to El Salam. El Salam has to leave in the end zone and just doesn't wind up enough and puts it in the turf.
El Salam can't see the clock from where he is. Clock's behind him. Might have thought he didn't have enough time, and instead of setting a pivot and really throwing it, tries to throw it with his feet a little behind him. Ends up putting it in the ground, and that's where Sliva's head is going to stay. Well, he's a little frustrated they don't get to go into overtime.
And El Salam, probably unsure exactly how much time was on that clock, wanted to get that throw off very quickly and just forced it a little too fast and a little too low to an open Sliva. And what a heartbreaking loss for the Rainmakers here at home. But a hard-fought game from both teams. Very exciting play from these two great teams.
Can't get much closer than that. It comes down to a pretty open last-second throw. But Portland's going to hold on to their lead 17-16 as they go up to 7-1, drop Seattle down to 4-5, and finally take revenge for the only loss of their season so far.
What a game here and a nail-biting finish. Coming up short of the Seattle Rainmakers as Portland asserting their dominance once again for the west coast of the MLU.
And they'll meet again next week, and the Stags going up to Vancouver, continue a little road trip as they're going to play the Nighthawks tomorrow, coming off of this nail-biting end. You'll notice the official disc of MLU is the Innova Pulsar. It's designed in cooperation with players and staff of the MLU, and the new Pulsar is the perfect disc for the pro game. You can get your Pulsar today at shop.mlultimate.com or visit innovadiscs.com for a look at the rest of their product line, including world-class disc golf gear.
Thank you for joining us here this evening.
You can see Ulta Photos. Ulta Photos is the official photography partner of Major League Ultimate. Ulta Photos features an elite core of Ultimate photographers across the U.S. and Canada who are passionate about the sport of Ultimate. They are available to cover your Ultimate tournament and capture incredible photo memories for participants and fans. You can check them out at www.ultaphotos.com and check out their complete MLU game coverage at mluimages.com. Lots of kind of photo finishes there.
Indeed.
As Portland holds on to that one-point lead, the game always within 2 points, the entire from start to finish. And Seattle, so close. They could
so
taste it.
Close. They got exactly what they needed in those last 2 points. They brought in Entz. Reed Koss sent a big backhand up to him, catching the goal. And then here we see some plays from earlier in the game.
As Tommy Rosato picking up some trash, doing a little celebratory bounce.
Norden launching one downfield to Friedman, who gets it up over Duffel, sends him to the ground, and that's just hard to stop there, finding Laurie in the end zone.
See that one again, it looks like. As Friedman, remember, kept starting that disc before the disc was even in, starting his cuts.
And I think probably improved on his 97% completion rate. I don't remember him turning one over this game.
Not hard to improve. Sorry, not hard to hurt.
There you see Trotter stomping into the end zone for the goal.
Chris Rupp shooting it up to Khalif El Salam, who moves it far in front. And Trotter jumps over the little fence that's in his mind in front of every goal.
Indeed. See Norden getting it off the swing, finding Laurie open in the end zone. Pretty solid work from both teams towards the end zone line. A lot of open cuts on the sideline after some patient offense. There you see it off of the continue.
Very patient red zone offenses there. As people take the shots they have, there's Trotter putting it way out in front. Huge window for El Salam.
Tridiak wisely looking off. El Salam the first time to take the easier shot so that Trotter can find him wide open there.
It's also been quite good red zone defense by both teams, forcing the offense to go left and right.
There you see
some red zone defense.
Yeah, Harkness shutting down Norden, who thought he had him faked out. High backhand sent low. Oh, no.
Laurie puts it out in front for Friedman, who blazes it down to the 2-inch tall Cody Bjorklund, who's actually normal height and has to drop down to catch that from the ground.
There you see Rupp getting retribution. Cole with a huge block earlier in this point. Rupp not going to let him get this one. Nice D from Chris Rupp sending it out the side. Of course, Portland got it back at that point and scored it again. And there you see that shot from Friedman again. El Salam would have loved to have it be that shot at the end of the game. Give Sliva a chance to catch it rather than the turf. And there you see Cole scoring an earlier point. Reed Koss sending a huge backhand up to Entz. This was with, they were down two, then down one. Isaac Entz comes in for a huge play.
That brought it within one.
And then Sharkness getting their final block of the game. And here you'll see Seattle moving it excellently up the field.
There's about 4 seconds left at this point.
And maybe just taking an extra half a second could have paid off.
Very painful to watch.
Oh, not giving Sliva a chance. He tried. He tried hard.
Not able to get there. And smiles, loving that finish, but puts his head on the ground after that one.
And probably close to 1,000 people here in Renton Memorial Stadium had a nail-biting game for their final home game, cheering on their Seattle Rainmakers. The Rainmakers coming out to greet their fans.
And that's going to be it for the home games at Renton Memorial. Renton Memorial MLU will be back next year. But until then, this is Jake Cooper.
This is Dave Bestock. Thanks for tuning in and watching MLU online.